Hey there. Welcome to Life Noggin. If you've flown on an airplane, you probably remember the safety briefing before takeoff. This might make flying seem kinda scary, but put your fears aside. You're actually pretty safe up there. There are less than 2 accidents for every 1,000,000 commercial flights, and even if you happen to be in one, you'll probably survive. Of the over 40 million passenger and cargo flights in 2016, only 10 had deadly accidents. In the United States, it's much more dangerous to be in a motor vehicle, where the odds of dying from an accident are 1 in 114. Before a new aircraft ever leaves the ground, manufacturers put the model through tons of tests that look at things like extreme heat and cold, high winds, excess water, ice, and lightning strikes. They even launch dead birds into engines to make sure the plane will stay intact if it accidentally hits a flock. Yeah, that's pretty extreme. The rigorous testing also includes the wings. You may have seen airplane wings bending up and down during turbulence, and that's okay. In fact, they're made to do that. If the wings were completely rigid, they would break during rough air. Instead, they bend a little to take the force. No, not that kind of force, different force. The Federal Aviation Administration in the United States requires that wings be able to handle at least 1.5 times the maximum load they would experience on a flight. Some can even bend close to 90 degrees without breaking. Just like the outside of a plane, the inside is built for safety. Your seat might be uncomfortable, but it could also save your life. Each seat can take up to 16 G's of force. It's also made of flame retardant materials, as are the walls and carpets. Wonder why they dim the cabin lights for takeoff and landing at night? It might help you fall asleep, but the real purpose is to keep your eyes used to the dark in case the power goes out or there's smoke. And if smoke blocks the overhead lights, there are lights on the floor that will guide you to the exits. There's also a reason your seat has to be upright for takeoff and landing. An upright seat locks into position and can handle more force, whereas a reclined seat can thrust forward, causing you injuries. Plus, keeping your seat reclined is dangerous for the people behind you, who won't be able to get out quickly or brace themselves. And bracing for impact can mean the difference between surviving and not. Although every accident is different, the best position for most people is to bend forward, seatbelt fastened with your feet on the floor, and your arms and head resting on the seat in front of you. This will keep your head from snapping forward into the next seat. It also might make a difference which seat you're sitting in. 2 studies found that people sitting near the rear of the plane were a bit more likely to survive a deadly crash. But this isn't true in every case, and there's no place where you'll be completely safe. The best way to protect yourself is to listen to the crew and follow all safety instructions. So do you love to fly, or are you a little scared? Do you have any scary flight stories you'd like to share in the comments? Let me know down below. So you're likely going to survive your next flight. Phew. But have you ever wondered if you can survive 2.5 million years ago? Check out this video. During the peak periods where most of the water on Earth was ice, the global average temperatures were 5 to 10 degrees Celsius colder than they are today. This was a much cooler and drier Earth. My name is Blocko. This has been Life Noggin. Don't forget to keep on thinking.